Global Education Media presents Education Report on TV, a television program that promotes educational events and activities for parents, students, practitioners in educational fields across categories, government officials, particularly those saddled with the responsibility of managing education, and the general public. It also covers programs and activities in the educational sector, such as awards and opening ceremonies, school inter-house sports, collaborative engagement with NGOs, as well as corporate organizations. Plus, vocational and technical education, institution for people with special education needs, individual contribution towards the growth and development of education while celebrating success in the educational sector at all levels. Please contact 0803-323-2771 or 0812-120-1359. Education Report on TV, promoting excellence in education on television.
As a government that recognizes the important role played by owners of private schools in Lagos State, the Lagos State Office of Education Quality Assurance recently organized a stakeholders forum where the Deputy Governor of Lagos State, Dr. Mrs. Idiat Adebule, met with operators of private schools in the state.
It is my firm belief that our dreams and vision of a better delivery of quality education in Lagos State will become a reality. Let me express my utmost appreciation to you all, our collaborators, for the sustained, robust relationship we have had within the last 10 months. It is my firm belief that this relationship will yield a positive fruit when at the end of the day, we can bridge the educational gap between children from public and private schools.
Speaking at the meeting, the Deputy Governor stated that the government would commence censors of private schools in the state and intensify regulations to ensure that the required standards are met.
Government is coming up with censors for the private schools. Yes, we need to know how many we have. If you ask us in Lagos State, they will say they have about 18,000, we have about 11,000. And how many of you are registered within the ministry? We have about 4,000 that are registered with the ministry. What is the comparison between those who are registered and, I mean, if you look at the ratio, the distance is quite too far. And we are not going to continue to allow things to continue like that. This is not right. And we are not going to allow it. We know there are low-income schools, but that does not make you, I mean, that does not give you the right to continue to operate illegally. And that is why, apart from the censor, we are working with TFID and DIPUN to do school rating, just like it is done elsewhere in the world. This, again, is so to ensure that we maintain the required standard in the sector.
The forum also served as a platform for the operators of private schools to ask questions while highlighting their challenges.
My question borders on the basis of, you know, checking the schools. We will appreciate a situation where before you go out, at least you call on our own leaders so that we can actually get to know the basis for all the rules and regulations which we are going to use in actually observing us. We will not want a situation where we will not know what you're coming to check and people will just fall on us without giving us enough notice.
There are rules and regulations guiding the establishment of schools. And that is why here, the ministry has put this together. It will be distributed to all of you today free of charge. Again, in there, when you go back, you will see some of the rules of engagement. Can we go through them, analyze them? And when there are questions for us, you all have the number of the Director General of Quality Assurance Office. You can, of course, refer to her and she will answer.
The area I'm a bit confused that I want you to please clear or assist the whole school in Lagos State, the private school, is the issue of the annual dean and the director's task. If you look at the two, the Lagos State is charging on the same thing. The annual deal is about what you made or the income in the school. The director tax is also about the school income. So if you look at the two, by the time the Minister of Education charges annual deal, the tax department also comes and charges on director tax. That is where we say we have a dogmatization.
That, again, you have to be deferred to the tax authority for them to make clarification. For the annual dues we are collecting in the Ministry of Education, again, it's not just any tax. We're doing a lot with it. And as you can say, that Mrs. Shiobo is trying, all that Mrs. Shiobo is doing in the private sector unit or in the Office of Quality Assurance, some of the information we have to pass, some of the things we have to do, is done out of this. It's not as if the money government is actually making a loss from that. But then, for the director's tax, I'm going to ask questions. There are ways we can help one another. I'll be glad to do that.
What is the stance of the government on the issue of anybody in Lagos State, in Nigeria, setting up a school?
Setting up schools anyhow, anywhere, is something that we are not pleased at all about. In particular, I am not pleased about it. Because it's not giving us, it's not adding value to what the major players are doing. So, one of the reasons why I'm engaging us here today is for us to restate the rules to one another. Because we are going to sanction. We are going to close down schools that do not meet the threshold. So, one of the basic reasons why we are meeting today is for us to distribute this particular terms of engagement that we have in our hands. Everybody to go back home and see how we can meet up. So when they come to, when those, the monitoring team will be in your area, it will be that you'll be ready.
In an interview with Education Report on TV, the deputy governor disclosed that the state government would sanction any private school that violates the laid down rules.
Government will not compromise on standard, will not compromise on quality teaching and learning in all these schools. We've advised them to please scale up and ensure that they meet the guideline guiding the establishment of schools. We recognize there will be low-income schools, but as much as we want to tolerate them, we will not go on to reduce the standard. We will not appreciate where people just come into the industry to establish schools without really being guided by the regulation and rules guiding the establishment of schools.
The Director General, Office of Education Quality Assurance, Mrs. Runke Shoyombo, told Education Report on TV that although some schools have met the standards set by the government, there are many others who are still lagging behind.
We've realized that quite a lot of our schools are working between good and outstanding at the moment. We've got few schools like that, and we've also got some schools that are fair. But what we're doing with those schools is to actually put interventions in place on how some of the schools that have come out as good or outstanding can easily mentor those ones that are fair or poor, if you see what I mean. And that's exactly the same thing we're doing with private schools.
Some of the stakeholders present shared their ideas.
She told us that we're going to have a CD free of charge, and it was given to us. Not only that, we were told that in the CD we'll have the terms of agreement or the terms of engagement, knowing what you are what we expected to do and what the government or its representatives will be coming to look for in our various schools. We are all going to be on our toes. It is to add value to the education sector, add value to our children, preparing them for the future, for the challenges, not making them mediocres.
So what we are doing is that we are moving forward with our collaboration, providing technical assistance to make sure that all the schools are covered and that we continue to have data on private sector education, even as the government has data on public education, for improved planning and efficient delivery of education services, because a number of children also move between the public and private sector systems. And so having a data that is comprehensive about both parts of the system is essential for planning and quality delivery of education services.
The outcome of it is to improve on what we have been doing under the Office of Quality Assurance, getting our school quality assured, as well as improving the standard of education in Lagos State. We really believe at the end of this meeting today, the hullabaloo about the increase in the annual due has been put to rest. looking at what the assurance given by the deputy governor. I equally believe that collaborative effort by the private and public will also move Lagos forward. Look at one of the challenges we have, like exam practices. And as stakeholders, we have all heard about it today, and we'll go home again to work toward making sure that our students are well prepared. And on another note, we equally believe the deputy governor has also come with a very good innovation, meeting us quarterly, so that our challenges from the local government level, from the state level, and as well as the federal level, will equally be resolved.
No doubt, two heads are better than one, as the Lagos State Government partners with operators of private schools in the state to deliver quality education. It is believed that the gap between the students of public and private schools will be bridged.
The Lagos State Examinations Board is announcing its registration and examinations timetable for 2016. Basic Education Certificate Examination registration is on the 7th of December 2015 to the 25th of March 2016. Late registration is on the 2nd of May 2016 to the 13th of May 2016. Examination date is on the 14th of June 2016 to the 24th of June 2016. Schools with albino and visually impaired candidates should write exams board officially so that adequate preparations for issues that may likely affect them during the examination can be resolved. Screening tests to model colleges and upgraded schools. Registrations on the 4th of January 2016 to the 29th of April 2016. Examination date is on Saturday, 14th of May 2016. Examination will take place in designated centers throughout the state. Interested candidates are to pay a sum of 10,000 naira. Once payment is made, teller and receipt of payment should be taken to examinations board for collection of registration customized CD. There will be two versions of the screening test, the paper pencil test PPT and computer-based test CBT. The two versions will be written on the same day. The CBT center is at the examinations board ICT room, while the PPT has 28 centers across the state. Placement test into public secondary schools. Registration is on the 1st of February 2016, the 30th of June 2016. Examination date is on the 9th of July 2016. Approved private schools will pay a sum of 5,000 naira per candidate. Public service examination. Registration is on the 1st of February 2016 to the 31st of March 2016. Examination date will be announced in due course. The examinations are listed below. External Secretariat exam for typist, combined confirmation and promotion examination, compulsory examination for admin and executive officer, and trade test for artisans in public service. Registration of all examinations will be done through customized CD. Public schools in Lagos State should visit examinations board for their CD, while private schools should visit examinations board with their receipt of payment from the bank and teller to pick up their CD between the period of registration for each examination. All payments should be made to Lagos State Government's account, Skybank PLC 40300104490, Fidelity Bank PLC 50300058723, FCMB 0135582346. For more information, please visit our website www.lagosexaminationsboard.net or call 080-235-480-336 or 080-285-18866. Announcer, the Director, Lagos State Examinations Board.